Hello, everyone. I wanted to introduce you all to a new friend of mine, and here he is. And as you can perhaps tell, he is an Eastern box turtle, just like Barnaby, the Eastern box turtle I care for at work. But this is a different guy here, and his name is now Tolba. And Tolba was living with the Division of Wildlife for about a year. After he was confiscated in southwestern Ohio, he was being held illegally there, and he was not being cared for properly. And as a result, he has what's called metabolic bone disease, which results in shell deformities due to lack of UVB, which comes from the sun. It can also come from a special lighting that you would purchase for your turtles. Now, he also is missing his tail, which is thought to perhaps have been from another turtle biting him. When he was first brought in to the Division of Wildlife's office, he was in really bad shape, but he was carefully nursed back to health, and he was provided for very, very well over the past year. So he was given to me just because I am a true fan of turtles, and it was known that I would take very good care of this little guy. And that allows Jamie at the Division of Wildlife to take in more turtles because there are always so many in need. Now, I live in Ohio, and Eastern box turtles are a wild species here. They are a species of concern, which means that they're becoming more rare. And there are some major reasons for that. One is habitat loss, just like pretty much every species that comes into contact with humans. And the other is that they oftentimes get hit by cars. And so they're becoming a lot less common in the state of Ohio and elsewhere in their range. I will post a map of their range just so if you're watching from somewhere else in the US, you will know where they are found and if they are found in your area. When I was growing up, people were always telling me how they were finding box turtles in their yards and so on, and I was always really jealous because I never found them around where I live in Northeast Ohio, not out in the wild. And as it turns out, they probably were not finding Eastern box turtles, but rather other kinds of turtles, and they didn't know how to tell the difference. These guys are a lot more common in the southern portion of Ohio, not so much in the northeast. So I'm going to show you, first of all, Tolba's setup for right now, which is how I've got it arranged at present. There may be some changes to it over time. And then I will take him out and you can see him up close and personal. All right, first of all, lighting is one of the most important things about keeping any reptile. And so I'm going to talk about that first. Now, I've got a lot of advice from the Division of Wildlife and also from my wildlife rehab mentor, Kristen, at Cloverfield Wildlife Care, who has cared for turtles with metabolic bone disease. So right now I'm kind of working out what works for us. So I did put both of the heat lamps on one side to establish a thermal gradient. The reason I did that right now is so that I can keep track of the heat and humidity as it is now, so that I'll know what it is. And Kristen has advised me to move the heat lamps to the center so that he's more exposed to the UVB throughout the day. So I probably will do that, but I first have to get an idea of how much heat that they are producing. So I've got two on right now because I do believe that I will need to have both of them in this space. The infrared basking spot is something you can keep on at night so that your turtle will stay warm if it is in a cooler area, because of course, being what we call cold-blooded or ectotherms, they do not generate a constant warm body temperature like humans do and other mammals and also birds. So you have to provide supplemental heat for them to be active. And you want your turtle to be active, so it'll be alert, it'll be eating, it'll be healthy, and all of those things. Same with any reptile. So this other one here is not only a heat lamp, but it also provides ultraviolet light. And this is, to me, a great innovation because back in the day when I worked in a pet store and I kept a lot of reptiles, we did not have UVB bulbs that were like this. We had a great big strip light that would be kind of like an aquarium light, and you had to put that over your cage all the time to give them UVB. Of course, you'd have it on only during the daylight, just like the sun. But now you don't have to have such a thing, so it's combined with the heat lamp, and that is what is in this big dome right here. So that is fantastic to me because the other was just, I mean, it's more convenient this way for sure. So we have got Tolba in what's called a 40-gallon breeder tank, and it's called a breeder tank because apparently it's used for breeding fish. But the reason I like this tank is that it's not as vertical as most fish tanks are. It is long and it is deep and it's low. And this works well, of course, for things that are not fish, because if it was very tall and thin, then Tolba would not really have that much space. Now, is this a huge, enormous, ample cage? No, not really, and perhaps I will end up doing something else at a later date. But he's got a water pan here, which of course he has been going in and out of, so it has to be refilled throughout the day. Isn't it cute? It has little dancing skeletons on it. I just happened to find it and I was like, oh, that'll work. I put a little thing of a wheatgrass in here just to kind of tempt him towards the greenery. Of course, like a lot of box turtles in captivity, he is not feeling very inclined to eat his plants. So I thought, well, perhaps if there's something in the landscape, he might just go on over and have a little nibble. And next to that is his cactus block, which is something I got from the Division of Wildlife. It was something of his to eat some calcium and other nutrients off of, and also help to file his beak down, because of course his beak does need to be filed down. And here's his little food dish, of which I am trying to give him the type of food that got Barnaby to eat his fruits and vegetables. So we'll see how it goes with this little guy. He might be more stubborn. We will see what we can do. But let me show you that in just a second.
So in his food dish, Tolba has got what I call an omelet. Now, it does not have any dairy in it, so no cheese or anything of that sort. But basically what it is one scrambled egg cooked on very low power, and in it, it has got red peppers and blueberry pieces. Now, this is the strategy that got Barnaby to begin to enjoy his vegetables, and he never really needed any goading to enjoy his fruits. But Tolba does, it seems, and so I thought perhaps by baking them into an animal food like this, it would entice him to have a little nibble, and then he would learn that they were tasty. Normally, box turtles are omnivores, and they do eat a lot of invertebrates in the wild, things like earthworms and slugs and various insects as well. Really anything they can catch. They would surely eat eggs if they found them in the wild, and they also do eat fruits and vegetables as well as mushrooms. Now, I've not been able to get Barnaby to eat his mushrooms yet, although I have tried to bake them into eggs like this, so we shall see how it goes with this little guy. Now you may be wondering, perhaps, why does Tolba not have a hide box, meaning a place for himself to tuck away into when he sleeps or decides to rest? And this is something that I'm considering, I'm working out in conjunction with Kristen, who's my mentor, who does not provide hide boxes for her turtle with metabolic bone disease, because otherwise, she will retreat into it and not get the UVB light that she needs. And so I'm thinking to not provide one right now in the wild. What they do is they burrow into the leaf litter when they are ready to sleep for the night. Or as well, in really hot summer days, they do that. And they also do that in the winter when they go dormant. So perhaps I will change that, but I wanted him to be out and active and to encourage him to do so. So I'm still kind of working out the details. Once again, I don't really want to change things around too much for him, but I also want to make sure that he is keeping active and eating, because I know that he had kind of started retreating a lot into his hide box at his old home and was not eating very much. So I thought, well, we should perhaps follow the advice on this and try to kind of reverse that little trend. So I'm going to get him out so that you guys can see.
All right, so here he is. And like all box turtles, Tolba is extremely charismatic. They just have these plucky personalities. They're very alert. They're very observant. And there's just something like recognition in their eyes when they look at you. So he's just wonderful. Now, he is not as big as Barnaby, whom you may know from my other videos, or if you know me and him in person. So he's a little bit smaller. Here he is compared to the size of my hand, so that gives you an idea. Now, I mentioned that he has the metabolic bone disease, which has resulted in shell deformation. So a little bit here on his carapace, as well as on his plastron, which for a male, which we believe that he is, it is not concave, which is the case with male eastern box turtles. So that could be a result of his shell having deformities. And he also is missing his little tail. So just a little stump is all he has got there. And he was in super bad shape last winter when he arrived at the Division of Wildlife, but he has made a tremendous comeback from what I understand, and he is extremely healthy and vigorously active in spite of having metabolic bone disease. So ongoing care for this guy is just making sure that he has enough calcium in his diet and, of course, a great source of UVB light. And in the summertime, actually, heck, in any season but wintertime, when the weather is favorable, this little guy will get to go outside and soak up some rays, just like Barnaby does in the videos you may have seen. So he is super adorable, and you can look forward to seeing a lot more about him since he is here at my house. He's been added to my education permit. So we will be doing lots and lots of programs with him to teach people about native wildlife and also about why you should not take native wildlife out of the wild. He's an excellent example because of what happened to him when he was taken out of the wild and placed in improper care. Because these guys are a species of concern, it's really important that they not be taken out of the wild really under any circumstances except by a licensed professional to provide them with rehabilitation care or something of that nature. So if you think that they are adorable and wonderful and you want one for your very own, as I'm sure many of you do, then maybe you might want to get involved in wildlife rehabilitation or something of that sort. And then you'd have a chance to work with these guys firsthand. All right, so that will be the end of Tolba's first video, and I will go ahead and put him back into his enclosure, and I'll mist him. He gets misted every day for the humidity. And oh, one more thing I wanted to mention is that these guys in my part of the world, in Ohio, in the Midwestern U.S., they are our only land turtle. So all of our other turtles are primarily aquatic. Now, this doesn't mean that you won't see any of them outside of the water walking across the roads. That's a misconception because, of course, they do migrate from pond to pond and they travel a little bit within their home range. But these guys live on land and they only go into shallow water to soak. They do enjoy soaking. It's also how they prefer to relieve themselves, at least in captivity. They will go into their toilet and then they'll do so. Now, these guys, although they are a land turtle, technically speaking, they are not a tortoise. They are more closely related to our water turtles that we have around here, and not as closely related to the various tortoises that you may know of. So, just an interesting point, I wanted to add that. Another thing regarding Tolba's eyes. Now, I'm going to go ahead and put him back in his tank so that probably the light there will allow you to see them
better.
All right,
now, if you take a look at Tolba's face, you will see that his eyes are a red color. Most of the time, if you see a box turtle with red eyes, it will be a male. There are a few females, apparently, who have this color of eye, but usually females' eyes are brown. Also, the males are more brightly colored than the females are. Females are more likely to be shades of brown. You can see that this guy here has got some beautiful yellow-orange markings. And these markings sometimes will fade over time, but if you give them a diet rich in beta-carotene, they will stay nice and brightly colored like Tolba here. So that's another important thing for these guys. And I'm not sure how old Tolba is. Eastern box turtles, like many of our turtles, they can live about as long as a person. So it would not be uncommon for this guy to be able to reach 70 years of age. Now, the way to tell how old they are is you literally, and I used to think this was a myth and couldn't possibly be true, but I've heard it from enough reliable sources, you actually can count the rings on their shell as if they were a tree, which sounds crazy, I know, but the rings occur when the animal has undergone a hibernation cycle. So you can tell how often they have hibernated, which should tell you roughly how old they are, particularly if they have been out in the wild where they would have to hibernate. So that is the way that you can tell how old they are. I certainly cannot make sense of Tolba's scales for sure here to tell you how old that he is. But he could well be older than we expect. Like, Barnaby is 40 years old, so he's a little bit older than I am. And that's a very humbling thing to think of an animal like this that indeed can be out in the wild, you could encounter it, and it could be older than you. So, pretty awesome. They are a real survivor and hopefully will continue to survive with our help into the future. All right, that's it for now. Stay tuned for more Tolba videos in the future.